person that he will enable you to make money your friend. Coming to Mr. Roongta, I think he needs no introduction. He is founder and CEO of apnapaisa.com and one of the foremost personal finance experts of India. He has been advising investors, common investors, very beginners also, who is benefited by his advice through his columns. And today we can safely say that he is on a mission to spread. This is my, I hope and wish that you also go very much benefited here. This workshop is sponsored by ICICI Pru AMC. And Apna Paisa, you know, we are online marketplace for loans, insurance and investments. But we are not agents for any insurance products or distributors for any of the financial products. And financial literacy is, this financial literacy workshops we conduct under the aegis of financial literacy mission, which is initiated by Apna Paisa for the larger benefit of all the investors on an all India level. So we will be hosting this workshop across all cities, many cities in India in the coming months. So today we are here and I hope and wish that you take away a lot of learnings from here and your life becomes very interesting and smooth when you have money, or when your money becomes your friend. So over to Mr. Roongta.
One big lesson that I learned when we started this workshop, okay, all this, I mean, we've been doing these workshops now for the last 18 months or so. We would have done about 50 workshops, you know. You always get your colleague to introduce you. So, you know, at least at the beginning of the workshop, there are good things said about you, right? At the end, we don't know. At the end, the verdict is something that you guys will do. I think what we're going to do, this workshop is a series of questions and answers. I think somebody, this isn't a seminar. I'm not going to get up here, speak to you. You really have to answer a lot of questions. It's only as good as how many answers you give, what kind of answers you give to each other, what discussions you have. We have, of course, courtesy of the sponsors, there is a gold coin that's a prize, okay? And that's, I mean, if either any of you guys are on Twitter or Facebook, you can do like Facebook, you can do that, you can put it on your wall. The best and participation here, I think Benu is keeping a track, and the person who's giving the best participation, whether in terms of answering people's questions or participating here, good tweets, anything, I think that he will win this 10 gram gold coin. That's just to make it a little more interesting and spicy on a Friday afternoon. Yes. Is looking at a road ahead. Can this gentleman afford to go on a long journey? Can he afford to go on a long journey? He doesn't have any, oh, you can't go to a place without a vehicle?
You can go, but you have to go to the street.
Okay. So he doesn't have the right resources. Okay.
He doesn't know the direction.
Diversion, sir.
He doesn't have a
direction.
Direction. Okay.
He is not focused on the direction.
He is confused also.
Sorry?
Confused.
He is confused. Okay? Okay?
He may not know where to go.
He doesn't know where to go.
Too many diversions.
Too many diversions. Okay? Right?
So he is thinking where to go.
He is thinking where to go. Okay? Is there anybody who thinks he can afford to go on a long journey?
He can go.
He can go, yes. Why?
But he needs some guidance.
He needs some guidance.
Means that every mode, every point of time will need guidance.
Okay.
He can walk something, then they can complete the journey.
What you are saying is he should plan his journey,
yes,
and take guidance when
that
he needs it.
Yes. Yeah, he should know his goal,
mm-hmm,
then he can take that particular direction.
He should know where to go. Wow, that's a, I mean, right now, how do you start on a long journey without knowing where to go? So
destination.
You should know your destination, right? I think that deserves a prize. Can be multiple places there, right? We just don't know. We need to know that before we can answer, right? When is he planning to go? Now, later? What will be the mode of transport? Is he going to go walking? Is he going to have a car? Is he going to have a plane? How long will that journey take? Then we will calculate the cost. If we have these answers, right, you can calculate the cost. You will calculate the transport cost, the accommodation cost. He should have the funds, right? How much money does he already have? Okay. Now, how many of you want to make money?
Everybody.
I don't see some. Okay.
I already made.
Yes. Okay. So you all want to make money. So let's equate it to this. All of you want to go on a journey, right? For what? You want to make money for what?
I want to make money now so that I can enjoy the luxury of life. Not at 60.
Okay.
When my health and when there is no fun in life.
Okay. Good. How much money do you want?
India for a middle class guy. He can't even buy a 1 BHK with his salary.
Okay. So I'm actually not asking about your fantasy, I'm asking about your goal. How much money do you need? You said
money.
You have a goal, right? To have a very luxurious life and retire today.
Yeah, at 40
you
should.
Sorry?
You need, that's why I came here. How much money I would need when I retire. A lump sum money, how much money I would need, depending on the inflation and all.
So you are very clear. So do you have the resources for 3 crores? So you got your destination right. 3 crores today. What about the resources? Do you have the resources for that goal?
Yeah, I planned, but unfortunately from last so many years it didn't went
according to plan. So at some future point of time.
Yeah.
Right?
Maybe in 5 years time.
In 5 years time. So in 5 years time, will it remain 3 crores? How much will it remain?
No, it may get increased by, let's say, 15% inflation. If you could add it more, roughly 4 crores rupees.
So 3 crores might become 4 crores.
4 crores.
Essentially, is what you're saying in 5 years time.
Yeah.
So your goal is clear. You're saying 4 crores in 5 years time. That is your goal for retirement.
Yes.
Okay. Anybody else? Anybody else wants to talk? So, when we go on a physical journey, right, we plan out things, right? You go out, you're going to Delhi, you also want to go to Nainital, you also want to go to Kashmir, you will check how much time it will take, do you have the time, do you have the money, right? Once you find that you don't have the money, suppose you don't have enough, what will you do? Suppose you are planning a physical journey, right, from here to Delhi, you also want to go to Nainital, you also want to go to Srinagar, okay? Now you don't have enough money and maybe you don't have enough time or both.
Cut down on the destination.
Cut down on the
destination,
okay? That's one way. First cut one destination. I will not go to Srinagar, okay? What else can you do?
Cut down on cost.
How do you cut down on cost?
Some cheaper hotels,
cheaper mode of transport. I go by train rather than going by plane, right?
Borrow the money.
Yes, that's another way. Yeah. I mean, we must learn from our government, right? Yes.
So I'll hire a travel consultant basically.
You'll hire a travel consultant. And what
travel.
Will the travel consultant do for you?
So I'll tell him my budget, like what is my budget all about, and
right.
I'll tell him you give me the you charge me as a fee separately,
right.
And you give me the best way rather than I finding out the cost of the hotel and not knowing the standards where exactly how much will be the budget.
Right.
So they have all the know-how of managing the thing. They have experience in doing it.
So there, I mean. He's saying, I don't know this, I don't journey every day. There are consultants who do this for a living, right? I will tell him my budget, I will tell him my number of days, and I will tell him my wishes. And he will try and fit them and give me the best plan, right? So that's a lovely way to do the journey. Now physical journeys most people are able to do, although very few people will engage a separate consultant, but I think we are able to plan that. right? When we start on our financial journey, except for this vague wish that I want to make a lot of money, everybody wants to make a lot of money. But how much? When do I need it? For what? Okay? Typically, what do you need money for? Apart from retiring, what else would you need money from? Anybody wants to share?
Luxuries of life,
buying a car,
children's
education. So children's education, how much, how old is your child, sir?
My child is studying
in 12th standard, right? And how much money do you need for children's education, for your child's education? Only then you will know. And when will that happen?
Now I can do around 10 lakhs.
10 lakhs you would need if she was doing it today.
Yeah.
Okay. You were saying something? Child's education?
Yeah, and for the health. To take care of health also if something happens.
In the future. For emergency. Right? So, it is about 16, 17. But let's say you have a child who's just 3 years old.
Yeah, it's my child.
Okay, great. Okay, so are you planning for his or her higher education? Is it
yes,
sir. You are. Right. Yeah.
So
but
it will cost around 35,000 rupees a fee.
That's for your regular expenses.
Yes.
You're talking higher education, right?
So, future after how many years? That is what you are saying. Mm-hmm. So after, say, after 12, she would like to do some. Okay. So now it would cost me. I just checked. Yesterday, the day before yesterday, the donation would cost in an MBBS around 30 lakhs.
Around 30 lakhs.
As
today,
a donation.
As a donation. Right.
Around 8.5 lakhs for the person as a fee.
So a humongous sum of money, right? A big, big sum of money even by today's standards.
Right.
Right? Let's take a slightly modest example. Let us say that you plan a course for her that if she did today, would just cost 5 lakhs, let's say, just for the time being, right? But she is not going to be doing that course today, she is going to be doing it after 15 years. What will you need after 15 years? How much will you need after 15
around
years?
Around 22 lakhs.
Around?
22 lakhs.
Where did you get that figure from?
Inflation.
Inflation.
What inflation? What percentage? I mean, that's such a precise figure you got. Okay, how did you get that?
I had heard that in 7 years in banks, money doubles. So banks give 8%.
Right.
So if it would have been by that, it would have been 20 lakhs. So
okay.
14 years, 20 lakhs. So I did somewhere 22, 23 lakhs.
Wow. Wow. And what's your name, sir?
Anurag.
Anurag, what?
Cool.
Okay. Good. Excellent. So that's the way you should try and calculate. That's called the rule of 72. Okay, I mean your calculations are a little wrong, but your basis is perfect. Okay, the way you do it is 72 divided by the assumed return. Let us say our inflation is 10%. We have assumed 10%, right? 72 divided by 10% will give you the number of years it takes to double. So bank's money, if it is they are giving 8%, will double in how many
years?
In 9 years, not in 7. Okay. So 72 divided by 10 is 7.2 years to double, very, very close, okay. But this, so what is 5 lakhs today, okay, is going to be 21 lakhs in 15 years time, right? Your figure is even higher. I mean, forget the semester fees, you're talking say just 30 lakhs. You should be planning for 1.25 crores plus, of course, you have to plan for the semester fees as well, right? So the key, I think, is you must know where to go, because unless you know where to go, you cannot even take the next step to find out whether you have enough resources to go there. I think most people don't even calculate how much money they will need. I mean, all of us want money, but I think there is a difference between need and want. You must at least calculate our needs first. Some of them are, whether it is your retirement or your child's education, all that is a need, right? After that, if we have surplus resources, obviously all of us want more money than that, right? But we must first definitely provide for our needs. So this, I think, a lot of you have seen. In this is a example that a lot of you, how many of you have seen it in the email that we sent? Okay, so then you are at least primed for this. We have, this is an actual example, a real life example of a client who came in and told us, what do you guys talk about investment? Okay, my father invested 3 lakhs in a flat in 1983. Okay, and that became 2.1 crore in 2013. 3 lakhs became 2.1 crore. That is 70 times in 13 years. Now, was that a great investment or was that a great investment? What do you guys think?
It was a great time.
Sorry?
It was a great time.
It was a
great time. It was a good amount.
Was that a great investment?
In absolute terms, yes.
In
absolute, but otherwise, no.
What is absolute and
absolute? Because it's a huge amount to front end. But if you calculate it initially from 83 onwards, it used to double in about 4.5 years' time. The amount used to get doubled.
Okay.
If you calculate it that way, it is 1997.
Right.
I guess it was 4.5 times, 4.5 years used to double, and later on it became 5.5 or 6 years. So it should have fetched him a little more than 2.1.
So you are saying that he has not fetched great return. That's what you feel.
Yeah, it could have been.
It should have.